Hello everyone.
Good morning, guys, and greetings from Nairobi.
To Nairobi. We're back.
No, but we came with greetings. Oh, you know, when we come from there, they say greet people from there. Yeah. Actually got back last night, or should I say last evening?
Yesterday.
We got back yesterday at 3 p.m. and we are still very tired, but life must move on because this month we are kind of on a marathon with everything. What else did I want to mention before I say today we are starting our moving. We shared with you guys our new house, so we are officially moving as from beginning of August. So today is Monday 29th, correct?
Yes,
Monday 29th, and we are headed to the house to collect the keys and to make sure the house is in expected condition, because there is some rules that should we ever plan to move out of this house, we have to leave it in the condition that we have found it. So that's why we have to go and meet up with the landlords there and the agents, and we make sure every little mark that is in the house we note from both sides, so that we can keep the house in the same condition that we have found it should we ever plan to move. Next thing, I wanted to shout out to all the guys who stopped and said hi to us in Nairobi, in the streets. A lot of you guys, thank you so much. And also there was some ladies from the airport in Doha. I'm sorry, we were so exhausted, we didn't even get to ask your names. But if you watch this video, thank you for stopping and saying hello. Leave a comment if it was you. I'll give you a shout out next video.
And to the one at Nairobi Airport Money Exchange. Midnight.
Yes, actually,
she recognized.
It was midnight, actually, you know, like we were all so tired, and we unfortunately did not find a direct flight this time, so we had to do like a one connection through Doha. So connecting flights with children can be very exhausting, but all the same, we thank God we were able to go to Nairobi, do our things and everything, and we came back all in good condition and safe. We will miss Nairobi, of course, for a few more months or years, who knows, God's plan. And now let's go to the new house and make sure everything is perfection. Fine. Yes, we are actually just outside the building right now. So exciting. I just wanna get you on my grid sometimes, on my grid. So that's it, the house is in perfect condition and we can go ahead and start moving in as from now. So the next step, we are driving towards a car renting place, and we are going to rent a big vehicle to load all the stuff we can. We also have three people moving in our things later on. So we have filled up the first vehicle. We have left the big guys moving the heavy stuff. We are going to the new house to drop the stuff we have already packed. So it's a busy day. Burning temptation, I just cannot hide it. thing is, most of the heavy things are in our house. Bad thing is, we still have a lot to do. Either way,
we are pretty confident.
It's all good news.
We got a bit of help, and that was very helpful. Yeah.
At least we got some guys who are very... They're not just doing small things to finish up their 4 hours. They're really doing it a lot. Yeah, so all is good so far. So, day one. The lounge is done, outside there. Going in, dining table is done. The couch is done. The TV is still in the old house. Those are our suitcases from Nairobi, unpacked. Avocados are overcooking in there.
They are in the old house, by the way.
Oh yeah, we unpacked avocados. We still have a lot of boxes here to go.
It's just the kitchen.
Yeah, this is all kitchen stuff. We need to unpack that, that and that. So pretty much the living room is decent for now. I mean, you can sit down. In this bedroom, it's full of boxes, which is clothes, shoes, all sort of things. And what we want to do is, we want to make Chloe's bed somewhere right here. And then she has her desk right here. And then this space here that looks like a corridor walk-in, we are going to block this wall, and she will have some kind of a walk-in closet here between this two curtain space. And of course, this is what I meant when I said she opens up to the kitchen area. This is the door. It's a sliding door, so she can close for privacy if she chooses to. If not, she will just open and she can come for a glass of water right there in the kitchen. As for upstairs, let's check that out. When you walk in to this similar sliding door like Chloe's bedroom, so we can close it or we can choose to open it up. And it's a bit dark here because we have blocked the window. I'll show you why. So this is Zoe's bed, as you can see. This is the space I've left for her. This cupboard, we have moved it all. It was blocking this side, but now it's blocking this side. As you can see, this is Zoe's space. Here we are going to set up her changing table and a few of her playing stuff down here, because she has a play area here with Chloe. When it comes to the master bedroom, the same sliding door which slides and opens up to the bathroom right there. So I'm inside the bedroom, that's the bathroom. The bed, we have already put up the bed, we just need to make it up, and the side tables are coming. So this is the bed area. So what happened is, on this side we have one of the cupboards, the ones we had in the old house. And all the cupboards that were in this house, they are these ones here. So I have cut Zoe's room and made this kind of a walk-in closet here for myself and Loti. So these are cupboards. All this is storage. We are going to add a mirror right there and the ironing board right here. So that is our walk-in closet we have made up like so. And in this corner open here, it doesn't look cute, so I'm going to put a plant right there. I'm going to put a plant. Of course, we have a lot of fresh air coming in from that window and this window. So that is the window that has blocked Zoe's bedroom. That's why it looks a bit dark in her room. But she opens up to the main door, which is fine. She has enough air. So that's the master bedroom. Still a lot of work to do. And of course, the bathroom. I showed you guys the bathroom. I've not done anything to it. We still have a lot to set up, and we will catch on as we continue to set this place to be a home. I think the couch area looks decent right now. Once we put the TV and a few plants and decorations, yeah, it's going to be good. We are just going to keep testing out things and see what works best. So you want to close the vlog from down there?
Sure.
Go ahead.
Okay, day one is done. We are done. We see you on day two. Have a good night.
That's it.
Today we are painting Chloe's bed, of course.
Nah.
What paint did you choose?
What's the name again? Lavender.
Lavender. Color lavender. Okay. So we are painting.
How long has it been since I kissed you? You held me. I don't wanna wait. How long has it been since I felt like this about anything? I don't wanna wait. I don't wanna wait no more. How long do we have to put up with this lonely charade? As long as I know that I'm winning, I play this game. But I want you close, baby, right now. I know you feel the
in the next vlog. Subscribe if you haven't, give a thumbs up on this video so we know if you want us to keep you updated on the new moving series, and subscribe if you haven't, like I said, share with your friends, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.